Good morning. Well, we had a very eventful day yesterday, but check this out. We actually made it up to Paradise Divide and found the best spot up here. It was completely empty, and this is what we got to wake up to this morning. Got breakfast cooking, putting the new Coleman Camp oven to the test. Gonna have biscuits. Yeah. Biscuits and sausage gravy this morning. There we go. So the plan today is to, we're not rushing around camp or anything. Making breakfast, gonna run Schofield Pass. A couple of us, at least him and me, are going to jump in Devil's Punch Bowl.
And make some money.
They bet him. I'm not getting paid for this. I don't know why. Maybe I made a mistake. Surely someone else will join us. I don't know. Anyway, we're going to take a quick dip in Devil's Punch Bowl, which I've done 2 years ago, and it was the coldest water I've ever been in my life. Ben has no idea.
I'm not ready for it, but I'm
going to
do it.
We're going to do it. And then make a trip around Lead King Basin, stop at the Crystal Mill, and then probably run into town, do some walking down the shops and shopping and, you know, get a new t-shirt while we're here. So, I'm going to keep going with breakfast. Hey, Nick.
Yes.
How's the biscuits and gravy?
Delicious. I've never ate so well.
They did turn out really well. Look at those biscuits in. Look at that. And the gravy. Oh, yeah. Schofield Pass was constructed in 1883 when Dr. John Parsons got permission from Chief Ouray of the Ute Indians to survey the Elk Mountains for agricultural and mineral resources. The road connected the towns of Marble and Gothic and was known as the SOB Trail by the miners because of the sheer rock walls making transportation difficult and the famed Devil's Punch Bowl. Schofield Pass has the reputation as being the most dangerous road in Colorado. There are deaths and very serious accidents every year on this trail. Several in our group said Schofield Pass was more intimidating than Black Bear Pass, which will be in part 4 of this video series.
You made it. My wife is making me walk down.
The biggest issue with Schofield Pass is that there is almost no room to pull over for oncoming vehicles. We got lucky here, and the other driver of the green Jeep was in just the right spot to let us by. And he was from Arkansas too. Small world. Lead King Basin is a fairly easy and very scenic loop around the north side of Sheep Mountain. There's not a lot of history about Lead King Basin other than a mine being discovered in 1903. The trail offers a lot of variety, including shelf roads, waterfalls, wildflowers, and amazing views of the switchbacks. We knew there had been avalanche debris blocking Lead King Basin on the north side, but also had heard that work had been done to clear the debris. Fortunately enough had been cleared to make our way through without having to turn around.
Coming down shouldn't be too big of a deal. Well, we'll find out from Ben.
As usual, Ben is never afraid to be the guinea pig and agreed to go first to test it out.
How well is he clearing that, John?
Yeah, he's good. Okay. He's cleared about, there's a one little small thing popping up, but really, yeah, about that much running.
It's so soft in the snow. Be really careful, because if you go too fast through this, you'll drift through that log. Because that snow is not forgiving.
It's snow. Well, it's just that you can't get traction. I know, that's
what I'm saying. Just... Yeah. Once
he's in, he's in. That's good. He's dragging the brush. He caught some of that. That's not good.
Oh yeah.
Let it glide. He's gonna need to go
back. Driver. Driver.
My leg. Easy peasy. Just drive through. Straighten up. Straighten up. Just drive through. You're good. Come on.
Don't lock the
wheel. Go for the next
The Crystal Mill is an 1893 wooden powerhouse located on an outcrop above the Crystal River. Although called a mill, it was actually a compressor station, which used a water turbine to drive an air compressor that was used to power other machinery and tools. It fell into disuse in 1917 when the nearby Sheep Mountain Mine closed. Today it stands as a Colorado icon and is known as the most photographed site in the state.
So me and Nick and Ben, are about to go swimming in Devil's Punch Bowl.
What is the Devil's Punch Bowl?
The coldest water I've ever felt in my life. It's basically just snowmelt. So here we go.
Oh,
Nick and I didn't have any money on this, and we're just doing it for fun, so we got out pretty quick. I can't stress how cold this water really is. Ben, however, stayed in there for 3 minutes and managed to make $40 in the process. One of the advantages to having a drone is you can use it to scout ahead, and since there was only one pull-off spot coming down the section of Schofield Pass, that's exactly what I did to make sure there was no traffic as we made our way back up the shelf road. And fortunately for us, the coast was clear.